Welcome to my let's try of Dragon Age Inquisition multiplayer edition. Well, it's not multiplayer edition. And here I got my friend with me, who is going to show me the ropes and a Fate 85.
Hello.
Little drummer boy.
Thank you for having me here.
All right. Press options button. Oh, good. End user license. Oh, I can just press X to accept it right away. I don't have to scroll it. Good. You entered a block scene. Yeah, that's because I'm connecting to the servers, apparently.
Yeah.
But they just block the... Okay, whatever. That makes no sense.
Anything, right? Yeah.
It's the same goddamn scene, except with the rotating circle thing connecting the servers. Circle with the thing part. Can't show that, but we can still... I don't know, anyway. Alright, let's see. That's weird. I can't use the D-pad to go up and down on the menu. Alright.
Yeah, you have to use the left joystick. Yeah, it is weird. It's like that in the multiplayer interface too, like when you log in and do a quick match and create match, and you have to use the left joystick to move. It's really weird. I don't like that design choice.
I'll be honest, every time I go to like scroll through things and whatever, I always use the D-pad. Always.
It's just nice to have the option, especially the
okay.
Game allows you to move with
okay, so right here, right away, automatically, it brought me into like a menu button, and then all of a sudden it goes to a select character screen, and I'm like, oh, okay. So, Legionnaire. Oh, yeah, that's right.
Oh,
okay. Legionnaire, Archer, and Keeper.
Go to the store. You should be able to get some free chests. I think you will be able to. If you go to the store and go to free, you might be able to get some free chests, which might give you another character. But I don't know if you want to use them on your first try.
Okay, well, I gotta select somebody right now, so I'm gonna choose Legionnaire.
Cool.
Well, okay, there's Archer and then there's Keeper. Is the Keeper the one with the barrier spell?
Yeah, the Keeper is a really good support class, and it's probably more survivable than the Lego for a new player, but you could try them all out and just see which ones you like the most. Like,
okay.
You know, it's really up to you. We should have enough time for you to be able to try them all out, at least.
We recommend new players start at the Proving Grounds. This typically takes about 10 minutes, and you'll receive a reward chest upon completion. If you skip it now, you can always enter the Proving Grounds from the character select screen. Would you like to enter the Proving Grounds now?
It's just like a tutorial.
I
can't play with you if you do the Proving Grounds.
Yeah.
I think that's just something that you have AI companions, and it teaches you like the controls and stuff, but they're really easy. So it's like, I don't think you need to do that, but it's up to you. I mean, I can wait.
You know what, for shits and giggles, I'm gonna go with no right now.
Cool.
I'm gonna wing it.
Well,
alright, so let's see. Okay, so you said go to store?
There should be some free chests for you.
Downloading data. Okay, there's a victory chest.
Yeah, well, it's one. That might not even be... Oh, maybe... Yeah. If you get a character armor, then you know you got a free character.
Okay, so... Oh, okay, X to purchase it, because it's free. Alright, Confusion Grenade. Wait, what does that say? Enemies with the area effect will attack other enemies for 20 seconds, okay. Ferelden Officer Longbow. And this
blue
is rare bow.
It's blue? What level is it? I don't remember what level.
Six. It's blue.
Well, I forget what, that's like not that good, but it's probably the best you'll get right away, so you might want to equip that on your archer. But it's not good, like you will get better stuff than that.
Right.
It's a level 6.
But do
six.
I have to be level 6 to use it?
No. It's just okay. That's the level of the bow. Like I have a, like level 27 bows are the best. Yeah, level 27s are the best in the game. But the best bow in the game is only a level 26, but level 27 is as high as they get.
Rock armor tonic grants a 200 plus to armor rating for 30 seconds. Jar of bees. The bees! Summons a swarm of bees at the target location for 30 seconds. The swarm attacks the first enemy that comes near it for 163 damage per second for 15 seconds. A target affected by the swarm has a 10% chance every second to become panicked. Cold resistance tonic grants a 60% resistance against cold damage for 150 seconds.
Yeah, those are good. For and they give bumps to your party. All the resistance, the ice, the fire, the lightning, and the spirit. If you stand next to a party member and take that, you will get your party member will get the resistance too. They're really good.
Ferelden Skirmisher Longbow, which is common. Acolyte Fire Staff, common. Healing Potion instantly restores 9001 health. I like how they added just the one in there.
You can, and as you're going through items, if you see something that you know you're not going to use, though it's your first chest, you might want to keep like one of each item. You can hit triangle and mark for salvage, and then you will salvage those items. And rogue items give you cloth. Mage items give you I'd have to look at the crafting here. It's been a minute, but the items for certain classes give you armor, give you certain materials which are used for crafting that class's armors. So mage armors are usually the hardest to get. But let's see here. It's cloth for mages. It's metal for warriors, and it's leather for rogues.
Okay.
So. And the salvaging runes, will give you one of each material. So salvaging those, unless it's a superb, anything less than a superb rune, you want to salvage, and that will give you one of each material at least, and that will make crafting armor a lot easier for you, which is like the big hurdle you gotta get over when you just start, because you have to craft armor to unlock the characters that you want to play that you don't start with, and you have to craft armor, upgrade armors for the characters that you have unlocked. Like they start with a lower tier armor set, and you can craft a stronger armor, and then you can craft another stronger armor over that, and then there are different looks if you want to get into it and craft something that you like the way they look, you know, if you care about them.
So okay.
That's what it.
Then I got a balanced dagger, which is common, and I got a sledgehammer, common maul.
Well, seeing as how you don't have any two-handed warriors or dual-wielding rogues, you might want to just salvage those two right away, because you only have a person who uses a bow, you have a sword and a shield, and you have a mage character. You'd have to unlock the other ones unless you get a free armor and a chest, which is possible.
Okay, so balanced dagger and sledgehammer can just be salvaged right away.
Yeah.
Okay.
And probably a few of the other things too. Like you got two bows, one of them's probably better than the other.
Yeah, the rare one, which is blue, has 60 DPS, item level 4. 6, and this one's an item level 4. The one for common is a 42 damage, 3 dexterity, and this one here is a 53 damage plus 2% critical chance plus 3 dexterity and increased maximum stamina by 15.
Yeah, it's clearly better. you won't have any use for the other one.
So salvage that one as well, or?
Yeah, definitely. There's no reason. There's you want to salvage as much as you can, because that will only give you more stuff to craft and unlock characters or craft better armor sooner. So there's no reason to keep anything that you're never going to use, unless you just really like what it's called, or you really like the way it looks, or any of the sentimental type.
Right. Okay. I see what you're saying. I'll get rid of it for now.
If it's a common, you'll be certain to see many of them. There's no doubt about that.
Right. Okay. So sledge, dagger.
Run to the little boy's room real quick. I will be right back.
All right. Okay. It's skirmisher longbow, sledgehammer, and balanced dagger is gone. Okay. I gotta remember this stuff. Drake stone, buffalo hide, and Bronto hide. I'll wait for him to get back. So, my PlayStation Plus is going to be up in the coming days, actually on the 3rd. So, I bought Dragon Age the end of December, around the beginning of January. I think it was around the end of December, to be honest. And, because I told my friend here, Dylan, that I would play with him. And we didn't really have any games in common. And he played a lot of this game. I'll tell you how good Dylan is. Dylan is so good at this game. He is in the number 2 spot on the leaderboards. That's how much he plays of this game. He's insanely good. But then he stopped playing for a while, and then he attended back to his drumming. So I don't know what level he's at now, but he was level 2 in the leaderboards. So I imagine he's still probably up there, but nowhere, my guess is probably not in the top 10 anymore. But I could be wrong, I don't know, I never seen what the leaderboards look like. But for the sake of this stream, I'm going to check at some point. I'm going to be like, and there he is. There's his name. So, yeah. So I thought, you know, I'll do a quick stream of this and I'll come back to it later on. Because that's what I'm going to do. I'm just making this as about an hour or a little bit over an hour stream. And then I'm going to get to other games. And then later on, when I get my Plus back up, I'm going to come back to this, and then I can be able to play this with anybody, and anything can happen. So, with that being said, it was supposed to be me and Dylan today, but I think his friend might join us. That's if his friend didn't impatiently, like, wait and leave or whatever. Which I feel bad for already. The first Dragon Age, a little history on my opinions on Dragon Age was Dragon Age Origins. I bought it because it was $40 and it was like on sale and the game wasn't out, you know, entirely too long. And I was like, wow, this is fun. I dove right into that game. I found that game fun as anything. And I even platinumed the game, because that's how much I enjoyed it. Like, it was so fun. It was so, so fun. And then when Dragon Age 2 came around the corner, I was told by a lot of people, like, this is a lot different of a game than what Dragon Age 1 was. And, like, you know, to stay the hell away from it. And then I had a lot of people where they were like, oh, well, no, it's still the same. Like, give it a chance or whatever. And I'm like, alright. Then I ended up buying Dragon Age 2 on sale for, like, $5 or $10 digitally on the PS3. And I played it, and I absolutely despised it. It's like the redheaded stepchild of the series to me, in a sense. I hate to say that because I have a fondness for redheads, but point is that I didn't like Dragon Age 2. And I was just, you know, very wary some about buying Dragon Age Inquisition. And I was told, no, it's better than 2. Like, 2 was just a misstep in, like, the awesomeness of what Dragon Age is. And I'm like, okay. And I bought it used because of the whole Xbox One exclusive thing they did with that one DLC. To show that I don't support that BioWare/EA. I don't approve of that, so I'm buying your shit used when you do that. I'm sorry. And the same thing goes to you be stupid for their Division game. You want to give Xbox 30 days for your DLC first? That's okay. If I'm a second-class gamer, I'll treat your shit second-class by buying it used. Just saying. Rant out of the way. So, with that being said, here I am with Dragon Age Inquisition, and I'm hoping that I enjoy it a lot better than 2. I'm sure I will, but then again, that comment might bite me on the ass later on. I don't know.
Just the effort that they put into it was much... You can tell that there was a lot more time spent on it. In the single-player world, you know.
Right.
That's what you're talking about. You can't really... Dragon Age... This is the first Dragon Age game with multiplayer, so... Did you get anything else good in your chests? I'm watching...
Okay, well, I'm still on the same thing there. I did, salvage. I got one Drake Stone. I got one Buffalo Hide and one Bronto Hide.
That's one of each, No, that's two rogue, two leathers and one metal.
Okay, so are any of them uncommon to come by or a little harder to come by, or are they all common?
They're all pretty common, I think. Yeah, they're all common.
Okay.
Like, that doesn't really matter until you start crafting upgrades for weapons. Like, you want to, when you're crafting armor, you always want to use, and dragon calls, you always want to use the lowest tier metal, leather, or cloth that you have, and save the better ones for crafting weapon or armor. To use higher tier crafting components on armor, because you will always get the same armor no matter what.
Right.
But for the armor upgrades and for the weapon upgrades, that's when the stats matter on those weapons.
Okay, so here's the chests I have left. I got Dragon Slayer, Call of the Dragon chest, and Inquisition Surplus crate.
Yeah, there, I'm watching your stream. There are.
Okay.
There are a few. It looked like you got a good amount of free stuff. You know.
All right, so I'm gonna open up the Dragon Slayer chest. All right. Hunting longbow, common bow, of course. Oh, I got a rare staff, glacial staff. Item level 5, 5% attack, 23 cold damage.
And that's pretty garbage. Like, just the level is, until you get something higher level, you'll probably want to keep that. Yeah. Just for your mage.
Yeah, when I see the word rare, I'm like, I'm keeping that.
like I said, level 27 is the highest. The items don't get really good until they're like level 18 at the lowest, is when you'll get something that you can use for a little bit, unless you get really lucky and get something really good right away.
Okay. Skywatcher's Lamellar set? I think it's Lamellar.
That's a sword?
Nope, it's a armor.
Then yeah, that's the Dragon Slayer is the free chest, which gives you one of the armor of the three new characters, either the Duelist, Isabella, Zither, the Virtuoso, and you got the Skywatchers, who is the two-handed warrior. You got his base armor for free, so that unlocks his character for you.
So and I already salvaged his item. Oh wait, no, that was somebody else, right?
You got a two-handed sword that you salvaged because you didn't have any other characters unlocked, but those aren't really hard to come by. You'll be able to, and they always come with standard weapons anyways.
Right.
So it's not a big deal.
Okay. Okay. So I unlocked a new character because of this, correct?
Yeah, that's what that means. And nice. Since you don't have characters unlocked, you will from time to time unlock a character from buying a chest or opening a chest. It's pretty rare, but you know it's cool when it happens because those unlocking characters takes a lot of materials to do. You know?
Right. We got a rare dagger. Slice of Lightning. 43 damage plus 5% armor penetration.
It's a pretty low level one, too.
Level item 5.
Well,
item level
I mean,
5, whatever.
I'd say if you were planning on unlocking any dagger characters, you'll probably get something better by the time you are able to do that. So.
Alright. I'm going to keep it because it's a rare for now until I get something else that's better, as I guess maybe. I don't know, I kind of want to keep rares just for the sake of keeping rares, but I'll probably end up deleting them at a later point or something. And then we got Legionnaire's Plate Oathbound. Item level 12.
That is an upgrade. Yeah, that is an upgrade for his base armor. So that will give you something better to put on a character you already have. Since you already have his armor unlocked, you don't have to craft his armor, so there's a chance of you getting his upgrades in the I don't think that is that the best one, I'm not sure, but it's a good one. You might be able to craft one tier higher than that, but that is still good because it will be better than what you start with no matter what.
Okay, that's cool. I'm glad that it's actually giving me some, knowing my luck, it's probably going to give me shit items, and I'm seeing this and hearing you say that, and I'm like, oh okay, well that's good. I'm doing better than what I'm expecting already.
Your luck of getting good items goes up the more chests you open to a certain point. Like, once you reach a certain point of opening chests, your luck won't raise any higher, but the more chests you open, the better chance you have of getting good items.
Right. Okay. So, backing out, not salvaging anything. I'm just gonna keep it as is for now. Alright. Okay, Call of the Dragon chest.
That one will give you a dragon's call for calling the dragon on the dragon map, which you usually have to craft, but that chest will give you one or two free ones. I forget how many. So you might want to save those.
Fire resistance tonic. Grants a 60% resistance against fire damage for 150 seconds. Mm-hmm. Kunari battle axe.
It's
item level 6, common.
Yeah.
What's that,
but
sorry?
It's better than the Inquisition. That's a two-handed warrior for the Skywatcher who you just unlocked. And since it's better than his, it's better than, Inquisition weapons really suck. It's what he starts with. So you might want to just save that until you get something better. It probably won't take long, but since you don't have anything else, you might want to save it.
Right. The exact same thing, Kunari Battle Axe, but it's a level 6, 90 DPS. The other one has 78 damage plus 6% flanking damage bonus. This one's got 80 damage, not 80 AOE damage, with the same percentage of flanking damage bonus.
AOEs are usually better.
Yeah, they're both AOE. 78 AOE damage, and the other one's 80 AOE damage, so it's a slightly bit better.
Yeah, unless it has a lot of crit chance or like a buff to your health or something, you probably would just want to use the one with better damage.
Dragon's Call. This hammer can be used to ring the ancient gong in the for Elden Castle, forcing the high dragon laying siege to the area of land, calling the high dragon, and in this manner destroys the dragon's call. So it's a one-time use, okay.
It's a one-time use, yeah. That's the Ferelden Castle is the dragon map. So that's where you go to fight the dragon. It's fun if you haven't done it before. It's pretty fun, and it's nice to have a change of pace every night. And like I said, that is where you have the chance of getting the game's best items. Or some of the game's best items.
Okay.
That's
cold resistance tonic grants a 60% resistance against cold damage under 50 seconds. Electrical resistance tonic grants a 60% resistance against electronic damage. Electric damage. Electronic damage? Yeah. I'm going to throw electronics at you. Electric if damage for 150 seconds. It's like, take this, PS4. Take this,
throwing your computer
PC
out the window. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I felt like doing when my computer died, which is still in the shop, by the way, if anybody's curious to know. And finally, Lesser Fire Rune. Adds fire damage to each weapon strike.
Our items, and it's a really... It's a really low-level rune. Like,
yeah, I have level 1. Sad Lesser Fire Rune is sad. Salvage. The game's like, damn it. Alright, I'm going to salvage the Lesser DPS Canary Battle Axe then, too. Alright. What do I get? Salvage the 2 marked items or crafting materials? Salvage. And I got...
Yeah, you want to salvage as much as possible.
2 iron, 1 bronto hide, and 1 cotton. It doesn't even look like cotton. It looks like one of those ripped off tags that you... Like, you know those tags in t-shirts? It looks like that. That or a patch that you would put on somebody because they cut themselves and it's like bandage. And now for the surplus crate. Acolyte Fire Staff, item level 2. Oh god, that's horrible. Round Wooden Shield, item level 1. Ugh.
Shields are kind of one of the hardest things to get. It's a really crappy shield, but you still might want to keep that just because it's better than the Inquisition shield.
Really? An item level 1 shield's better than the Inquisition shield? Oh, that's
lucky. Check the stats. You go to your inventory and check the stats, and you'll see. Pretty much, like, at the beginning of the game, you'll want to salvage, like, 99% of the things you get at the beginning of the game, because you will get better things.
Okay.
And crafting is such an important part of being able to improve your character's survivability.
Healing potion, 9,001 health, obviously. Healing potion again. And finally, Ferelden Army Longbow, 42 DPS, item level 2. Yeah, so I imagine I can salvage that too then.
Yeah, you already have a level 5 bow that you just got recently.
Salvage. And I'm gonna salvage the Acolyte staff as well. I don't know. Should I? Acolyte Fire Staff?
Well, actually, stabs are... I mean, you probably want to get rid of it eventually, but stabs are a funny thing. They have different types of damage. They have electric, they have fire, or they have cold.
Okay.
And certain enemies are more resistant to certain things. Like, when you fight the dragon, you can choose... You can either have it set to random, or you can choose the type of dragon you want to fight. And if you fight an ice dragon, obviously fire will be much more damaging against it than ice. So you might want to keep one of each kind of different staff.
Makes sense.
Until you get
All right. To be honest, thinking back, I don't think that acolyte staff or whatever I got had any kind of elements to it or something. And if it did, I don't know what it is, but I don't remember seeing an element to it. But all right, I'll just do the Ferelden Army Longbow.
Cool.
So let's see. You want to salvage the longbow for craft material. Salvage. One item. Ooh, ram leather. Ooh. Classy.
Where the hell are we going? I don't even know where the hell we're going. I am honestly super freaking lost right now.
Okay, so... Oh yeah, I'm still in the store, right?
I have no idea where we're going. I'm so lost in this fog. Oh my god, I totally haven't played this game in forever. I have no idea where we're going. Don't follow me. Oh, it's this way. It's this way. It's totally this way.
Crafting abilities.
I'm just playing a pug match, and actually some of my friends jumped in. Because I know pretty much everyone who plays. But I will leave immediately when you're done with the training grounds.
Oh, I wasn't going to do that. I was just going to jump right in.
Oh, you are? Okay. I'd rather finish it just to give my teammates the experience. So if you want to do the training grounds and learn...
Okay, well... How do I go about doing that now?
You hit triangle for character select, and you hit L2 for enter the training grounds.
Oh, okay, I see it here. All right. So where's the? There's the
app. I just killed a lot of stuff,
right there.
So far left, I would take a big chunk of experience away from them, and I would rather not do that. We're on the last round right now. So it will be like 2 minutes. So if you want to wait 2 minutes, or if you want to do the Proving Ground might take you a while because...
It said it was going to take about 2 minutes, so I'll just hold off then.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I thought you were going to do the Proving Grounds.
Otherwise, yeah, no worries. Avoided. Okay, so...
And we're on Perilous.
Heartbreaker. It's like, nope.
Yeah. Heartbreaker is fun if you have a really strong party, but it would be suicide right now for you. I guarantee that.
Yeah. I'll be like, hey, guys, what's going on here? Wrecked.
Yeah.
Oh, God. All right, I'll put it on Nightmare.
Nightmare's pretty hard, man. You might want to, like I said, Perilous or below would be probably what you want to start at. Because Nightmare is really hard, and I don't have anything... I'm leveling a character right now, but you will die a lot on Nightmare. Like, there's no
okay, I'll put it on Perilous.
I'm doing Perilous right now with my level 1s.
What map are you on?
I'm on the Elven Ruins.
Okay. You know what? In my opinion, I think they should have added more maps to this. They could have done a lot more on multiplayer for this. I mean...
They really should have.
Like, four maps. I mean, come on.
And it took them 6 months to release the fourth map.
Jeez.
It didn't come out till like, April.
Yeah, that's disheartening.
And Xbox like, they could have...
Like, I know they had to, you know, jump off the Dragon Age bandwagon and go on to Mass Effect, but, I mean, they could have done so much more with this. I mean, I know they've been doing things for free for the multiplayer, and I thank them for that, but... They could have at least been like, okay, instead of doing like four or five maps, we're gonna put like a higher number and like do more areas. Even if you did throwbacks to the older games, like
I know a developer, I talked to a friend. I have a developer on my friends list, but I never got a chance to play with him. And I talked to a developer who developed this game from BioWare. And a friend of mine talked to him and said that he had an idea that never got to be implemented because they ran out of time. But he was wanting to have maps that were like almost procedurally generated, like they would change each time you use them, and like they would branch off in different paths and go different ways. And it's really too bad that we just finished, by the way, so I'll leave and join you. And it's really too bad that never was able to happen, but they ran out of time for it. But there are four different maps, and three of the maps, the Elven Ruins, Tevinter, and Orlais, each have two different maps. They have a nighttime and a daytime, or like they have different routes, so it's not always the same map, but you get pretty used to them pretty quickly because there's only
right.
that many different maps.
Yeah, like, because I hate that, where it's like, you play the map once, it's never going to change. It's always going to be the same outlay, the same enemies, you know exactly what's coming up, and I hate that. I hate knowing that, because it feels like a really cheap cop-out way. Like, I wouldn't mind if they made more maps, but they actually charge. If they made, like, a map pack for, like, 5, and they charge, like, say, $15. I mean, you know, it would have been something. Like, I mean, free is always great. I'm not complaining about the free stuff, but, I mean, I just kind of wish there was more.
Yeah, like I said, we finished the match. If you want to create one and invite me, I'll join you.
Creating match.
Do you care if I invite someone? Because I was just playing with a friend who I left to...
Okay, here we go. All right. Inviting friends.
That I did just get the invitation.
Send you an invite, by the way.
I'm joining right now.
I have it on private, but you said that you think you were able to actually invite your friend, right?
Yeah, if I invite them to a private room, they should be able to join. It's just that they won't be able to join through my name, I don't think, unless they're on your friends list too. What? It says the downloadable content does not match what is required for this session. I don't think we have the same DLC installed. It says I can't join your game.
Wait, what?
Yeah, that's what it's saying right now. I'm trying to join again. I joined through the party and it said that we don't have the same DLC installed.
Oh my god, really? The last time I had to deal with shit like this was on the PS3 for the Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2 game. God damn it, EA. One fucking job, man. One goddamn job. One job. Alright, so how do I find out which DLC it is that you have that I don't? That's causing this to...
Let me see what this is. It gave me the same thing. I'm going to go to the PlayStation Store. And, you could check in your... you could check in your notifications, your downloads, and see which updates and DLCs you have, which add-ons you have for Dragon Age. I know you have the Dragon Slayer. You might be missing the destructible...
Okay. I just want to say to those who are watching from Twitch right now, I apologize. I greatly apologize, but I have to go and check and see what DLCs I'm missing that I cannot play with my friend here. So, please give me a few...
I'm sorry to interrupt you.
Please give me a few while I figure this out, and the faster I get this done, I have quick internet, so I should be able to download this pretty quickly. And then I can be able to get into an actual game here with my friend that you can, you know, sit and watch me try it out there. So, all right, here I am, blue screen. I apologize for it. All right.
Yeah. If you go to the PlayStation Store and search for Dragon Inquisition, all of the free ones are downloaded, or all of the multiplayer add-ons are there. So we could look through and see which ones I have that you do not have. And should be only two.
Okay, I got Destruction Multiplayer.
You have the Destruction Multiplayer expansion. You have that one?
Yeah.
And you have the Dragon Slayer one.
And I have Dragon Slayer, yeah. And I got the Black Emporium. Yeah. I did them a while ago. Like, many, many months ago.
Yeah, you restarted the game since then. Played the games.
Well, I mean, this is the first time I got into the game today, but when they came up onto the store, that's when I grabbed them, when they were free. And then today was the very first time I jumped into Dragon Age Inquisition, and it said something about, like, DLC, and it was loading up the game, and then it took me right into the game, and that's when I started my stream, but...
You have the Destruction multiplayer extension, and you have Dragon Slayer. I have single-player DLCs installed, but that shouldn't affect it at all. There's nothing that I have that you don't. If you have the Dragon Slayer and the Destruction multiplayer expansion, and if your game is updated, and there should be no reason. I don't see any reason why we would play. Let me try to close the game and restart it. Maybe you want to do that too. I don't know. But if you have those two downloaded, those are the only two that. I saw.
Okay, let me ask this. How do I know that they are indeed installed?
You go to your downloads and you see if they were installed that way. That's what I did.
Alright, go to my downloads. Oh wait, download? Oh god, downloads. Yeah, I don't know if it would actually be there or not. Version 1.12 was installed back on the 19th. The update file.
For Dragon Age?
Yeah.
No. Oh, January this year?
No, it was the 19th is when I had it.
February.
Yeah. The version 1.12 patch.
Yeah, I have that too. I'm on the latest version. I'm on 1.12 as well.
God's name.
In fact, this is when you're downloaded, not when they released. Because they stopped releasing anything for this game months back. They stopped releasing it. So in your downloads, do you see that? I know the Dragon Slayer is installed because you got a character from it, like I said. But do you see the Destruction multiplayer expansion installed?
I don't even think, like, yeah, but my list is only so long because I don't know. Let's see here.
Well, that's the only thing that could be causing it, because you got a character. Maybe it's less than a gigabyte, the Destruction multiplayer expansion. Maybe you could try re-downloading it, but I don't know.
Okay, I got Dragon Slayer here, the Black Emporium. Dragon Slayer, Black Emporium. I'm still going up the list here.
Well, I don't know, if you don't see the Destruction multiplayer one next to the Dragon Slayer one or close to it, I would assume you would have installed them both
Yeah, I thought I don't. Well, it says I purchased it, so I guess I don't, because it's not here on the list. Black Emporium and Dragon Slayer. Okay, so wait, what one is it that I'm missing again? Dragon Slayer Emporium. God damn it.
Yeah, you might have purchased it. It's free. It's the Dragon Age Inquisition Destruction multiplayer expansion. You might not have installed it. That's the only thing I can think of.
But I thought the moment that you already purchased it, I thought it went and installed it right away, just like the other two did.
I assume it would too, but the only thing I think of is just because you can't find it on your updates or your downloads.
703.6 megabytes. Good grief. By the way, I do have enough space for that. I can guarantee you that. God. Oh God, are you serious right now? Really? You better bring that down. This is 60 minutes. I got fiber optic internet and it's saying 60 minutes for not even a gig file. That's asinine. Minutes left.
Yeah, it seems like it's dropped.
52. Well, I guess if you want to go off and play some things there, I guess I can go and stream the Proving Grounds while, you know, that stuff happens there.
I guess you didn't have it downloaded. Is that because it's downloading right now? I would assume.
Yeah,
right?
I could have sworn I had that downloaded because every time I clicked it, I always went to go and download things. I don't know why it was gone, but I don't know. Whatever, because when I would go into my games library list, it said 3, so I assumed that they were all downloaded as well, because that's where I looked at it under. There a couple days ago, and I'm like, yeah, everything's installed, but I guess that part wasn't installed, it was just the two. But under the disc, under the library section for games, it showed 3, like, you know, like I had 3 add-ons for it or whatever, so I assumed that they were installed because it mentioned 3. Alright.
Dave says, okay, home to the PlayStation. Home screen, and on the bar that lists all of your games, go to the DAI like you're going to start the game. From there, go down to related items and click on that, and the add-ons on there will be my add-ons. All the DLCs you have installed will be there.
That's, okay.
Unrelated items.
Oops.
Nope. Oops.
Alright, I'm going to install, or I'm gonna use the Avar character then for this Proving Grounds.
Yeah, if you want to check that too, just to see what you have, because it says all the add-ons that you have, and then, I think, and then you'll know for sure whether or not you have the all the same ones as me installed. If you just go to my add-ons in the related items at the start page, or like the home page of your PS4 screen. Like Dave said, you just click on Dragon Age Inquisition like you're gonna start the game.
And then you go down, click on related items. And then you go to my add-ons, and that will show all the DLCs that you have. I'm looking at it right now.
Yeah, this is my add-ons, 3 items. No, 2 of them are installed. The one there that I clicked to just download, or to install, it says it's going to be ready in 44 minutes.
Well, that's good. At least
downloading. At least we know. I mean, we already knew it was downloading, but if it wasn't installed before, it's going to be installed soon.
Now. Yep. Okay. All right. So, how do I view, like, what items I have for this character?
You go to inventory, and well, you choose that character. Yeah, you choose that character, and then you go to inventory, and the only weapons he can use are the two-handed warrior weapons, which are the second ones from the right. The second one from the right, which is like, you know, looks like someone's holding a big axe.
Kunari battle axe.
I hope that DLC does not take 40 minutes to install.
In my opinion, it shouldn't, but you never know. But, I mean, I have fiber op internet. This thing should be going like that, but maybe because I'm streaming, it's cutting it down some. Though, in my opinion, it really shouldn't, because, I mean, it's really, really high speeds. But anyway, yeah, alright, so... Alright, L2, enter proving grounds. Are you sure you'd like to enter proving grounds? Yes. Create match. Please wait.
Yeah, I'm just doing a quick match right now, too, killing some time.
Runes can be permanently attached to weapons or staffs to add bonus damage. Enemies can make your screen go black that you can't read the rest of this comment, or this message, or this hint. God damn it, enemies. Yeah. Troll.
Enemies.
They're taking enemies a page from your book.
Yeah, that sucks.
Welcome to Dragon Age Inquisition Multiplayer. As an agent of the Inquisition, you will be together with other Never mind. Couldn't read all that either. L to move around, R to control the camera, L3 to... It looked like it said strafe. Press X to jump over obstacles. X to open lock doors. Okay. Dun, 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 dun. What's going on, homeboys? What in God's name is that? Alright, here we go.
You have assigned your circle button. I mean, play around with your skills and have some fun. It's a good way to learn.
God.
I can tell you all about them, but the best way to learn is just by doing it.
What does L2 mean? Oh, okay. So holding L2 and pressing R1, because it shows a picture of a heart, I assume that's healing potions?
Yeah. And you can hold, you hit L1 to take one of those, to take a healing potion, or you hold L2 to see the other potions you have assigned to other slots, but since you're a new player, you might not have many assigned. Just advance undercover. Kill the spiders, I don't want them.
Oh my god, this guy, like, moves so goddamn slow. Not sure if want. A gold nug has appeared.
Here's another trick for you. You hit the R3 button, or the L3 button, the button you use to move the D-pad, you hit that down once, and it will make your character move faster. It's like the sprint button. Except you don't have to hold it, you just hit it once, and you should be moving quicker.
Wait, how come I'm only hitting... Okay, what's the attack button?
It's R2. You hold R2 for basic attack. You hold it.
Oh, okay. Well, a gold nug appeared, but now he's gone, I guess. I suppose. I don't know.
Those give you more gold. You kill them, and they give you a lot of gold. Like, if you ever see a gold nug, you want to try to kill it. It's like a little mini-game within a game.
They're like, gold nug has appeared, and I'm like, where? What does it look like? At least they could have zoomed in on it by camera, so I can be like, oh, that's what a gold nug is. Okay, then. Let's do this. Some areas are blocked off as a warrior. You can approach the doorway and press X to smash through and enter the room. And it says press X to bash. Nice.
Yeah, you're a warrior, so you can open the bash doors. Locked doors are for rogues, and magical barriers are for mages.
Okay, can I break these? Nope, okay. Alright. Wham. There we go. Dun 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 dun.
How long is that download, or how's that download doing now?
I have no idea. I wasn't gonna check it until after I was done doing this. Oh, we got a chest here. Loot! Plus 29 gold. Oh, baby, I'm in the money now. Better not spend it all in one place.
Yeah, I think that's how much gold it gives you from a nightmare run. So, pots on Perilous will give you like 26-ish. I think it might be Perilous or Nightmare, I forget. But pots give you a certain range of gold depending on the difficulty that you're on. So that seems like a pretty decent amount of gold, being that it's a training, a proving ground mission, you know what I'm saying?
Right. Okay, so there's these like stones that are kind of like glowing and they have like a skull on them. Are they for anything or are they just decoration?
They're just decoration. Actually, no, they tell you, those will tell you what kind of enemy you're facing. If you see those stones, you know that you're fighting demons. If you see boxes, that will tell you you're fighting Venatori. And if you see red crystals, or boxes will either be Darkspawn or Venatori, because they added a new enemy type. And red Lyrium crystals will mean you're fighting the Red Templars. So those will actually tell you, before you even see an enemy, what type of enemy you will be fighting. Oh, so okay. It might be good, so you will know to be prepared for certain enemy type.
Did you say press down on L3 and R3 once, or hold them down?
I thought it was just, it's just L3. I thought it was just once, but maybe you need to hold it down? I don't know, it's been a while since I played. Here, let me try again. Yeah, I think it's just you press it once, and you should be,
Yeah, I've been doing that. Oh my god. Alright.
So if you're not moving quick enough, then try holding it, I guess.
I'm moving. Moving as quickly as this thing's gonna allow me to. Alright, so apparently I don't go through that door. Herder. How do you game? Oh, god damn it. Okay, what am I missing here? The other way must have been the right way. Obviously, because... reasons. What in God's name? Come on.
Yeah, I'm watching you right now, cruising through the training grounds with your Avar.
Okay.
Do you like the Avar at all? And his skill on your square button.
Yeah, I've been attacking with that, and I'm like, man, I'm attacking slow, and you're like R2, and I'm like, oh, okay.
You can use. Actually, there is an attack animation canceling.
Oi.
You can use. You just hit the R3 button in between your basic attacks before you finish, and you will be able to attack cancel and make your basic attacks quicker. But it's kind of a pain. It works and it does a lot more damage, but it depends on how, if you want to use it to attack cancel and get all those. Where the hell are these items? Oh,
a key was granted to the entire party. Okay. Patch up
when you can between objectives. And I was going to say...
Use the health font at the beginning of each zone to restore... Okay, sure.
And I was also going to say, your skill on the square button can be used twice. You don't have to wait for it to cool down. That skill is an elemental attack, so what you do is you use its base form once, and then if you use your ice charge, then it turns into an ice attack, and then you can use it again, and it's different from its regular attack. And then he has fire and electric attacks.
I pressed square twice, and it only allowed me to do it once, by the way.
Well, you have to use your ice attack after to reset its cooldown.
Oh, okay.
Use your circle button. Because what you have to do is, you can use it as a basic attack.
Oh, I see it now.
Yeah, right. Yeah, and then after you do that, and then after you use an elemental skill, it will trigger that skill to be a different elemental damage.
Right. Plus 7 gold. Dash. Okay. Come down here. Oh, then we're good. Time to bash this door. Wham!
Never seen anything like that.
Plus 24 gold. Yee. And before Black Painter Red will come into my stream going, Pastor didn't wait for me, sad face. And I'll be like, damn it. Sad faces everywhere. Oh, wait a minute. I just looped around. Never mind. Recover the weapons. What weapons? Alright, guys. Attack somebody. There we go.
I actually have a friend who also never plays this game. He just sent me a message asking if we wanted to play Dragon Age together. So, as soon as you get those updates installed, the DLC, I'll invite them. Because they stopped playing this game a long time ago, so they're not like a super, super OP character.
Right. And us. You better tell them that they're playing with a complete, like, well, no, I was going to say complete random. A guy who completely doesn't know what's going on yet and is learning the ropes. So I don't want them to be all like, oh my god, this guy, so slow, he's back here hitting everything with his axe, and he's taking his sweet time. Oh, we got a fire one here.
Yeah, you're fighting demons. Where the hell am I going?
Yay, I got the key! Okay. No, I don't want to open that yet. I know there was an area back here I didn't adventure in. Now I just need to go find it, of course. I'm pretty sure there was an area I didn't adventure in. Yeah, here. Here we go. Damn! Alright, what do we got? Okay. Anything? Oh, here we go, over here. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Bam. So, for those who are watching that usually watch my stuff, I've been having this plan for quite some time. Eliminate guardians to break seal. I targeted it on the chest by accident. Or the barrel. Okay. He's dead. Okay. Yay! Plus 28 gold! Now to go to that locked door. Dun 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 dun. Look at me go. To use the recovery font to heal injuries. Okay. When they call this font, I'm like, you want me to use font? Like, when I think font, I think, like, you know, like, bold, italic, underline, you know, for, like, characters. when typing. All right, here we go. Open. Using your radar, find the Inquisition banner location. Head towards it. As you near it, a white circle is visible underneath the banner. When you, God damn it, I couldn't read all of it.
See that?
Okay. Defeat all hostile forces. Wrecked.
Wow, my team sucks so bad. They're not working it together at all. I'm totally going to die.
What difficulty are you playing on?
I'm playing careless, but I'm a level 1. And we're fighting a dragon map, and there are a lot of enemies that you can pull the dragon on a dragon map.
You're playing perilous?
Yeah.
Oh god,
I'm
that...
I'm a level 1 too.
Yeah, but that doesn't team... speak well.
We had a bunch of weak players, and the person who is strong is like off doing his own thing and not really helping at all. Look, like he left the boss to be alive a long time, and we were all trying to kill the boss, and it didn't work out. Cause I'm a level 1, I have no heal on kill either. I just put boost damage, like if I put heal on kill I would have been A-OK. But instead I put boost your damage on, and it didn't work. Oh, I'm an idiot. I have these potions I can use though. Oh shit, maybe I should use them.
So this map that I was playing in, was that like Elven Ruins or something?
That was Elven Ruins, yes.
Okay. Complete challenges to unlock new schematics, banners, and titles. Okay. I didn't get to read any more of that, but or any more after that, like the other cards. But whatever, you know, it's all good, right? So, level 2 ever! Yeah, 473 gold. Personal best, 14 minutes and 47 seconds. Even though the thing said that it would take me 10 minutes. But then again, I was mainly rolling around, looking around, I guess.
I totally forgot that I took heal on kill off my Necro. Makes her much... less
harder?
Survivable. Yeah, because you don't get heal on kill, and I am a level 1. And I don't have the skills set up to, I'm dead. I'm just gonna keep dying.
My download is... Ah, shite. Okay, I got 23 minutes left. It's half done.
Died, and I died 3 times. Then it's time to kill the boss. No, we
seems
should
legit.
Kill this bitch earlier. God damn it. She's the squishiest fucking one, too.
So now that I've done Proving Grounds, I can prestige, right? That's how it works, right?
What level are you? No,
I'm just kidding.
You have to get to level 20. And I would recommend just prestiging as soon as you can.
Yeah, I'm only level 2.
Yeah.
Oh my.
Okay, well, I'm just finished too. So I can join in. Oh, no, it's not finished yet.
Yeah, exactly. Friggin'. Can I do Proving Grounds again, but with another character?
Should be able to, yeah. I don't see why not.
I'm gonna try out another character. I'm pressing triangle and it won't allow me to go to the character screen. Oh, select the store tab to collect a free chest. Oh, never mind. Okay.
Free chest for that.
Never mind.
I'm definitely leaving this lobby. It's not good. Of course, I was stupid. It's more my fault than this guy's because he did carry us. But, he did not. He was not a very strong team player. Fuck that.
Healing potion. Oh, I got a claymore. Too bad it doesn't beat the Canary. Maybe it... I don't know. Maybe it does beat the Canary one. I can't remember what my Canary Battle Axe does. But anyway. And Ferelden Captain Lawnsword.
That might actually... Oh, I don't remember. That one might be decent, but if it's a low level, it's not.
Yeah, it's item level 4, 56 DPS.
I'm thinking of a different one.
50 damage plus 3 attack. And the claymore is 77 DPS, 68 AoE damage plus 3 attack. I'll just keep it for now. I'll just salvage it another time, which I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be doing anyway. Select inventory to equip your new items.
There's no reason. If you have something better, unless, I mean, especially with common items, like, there's no reason to keep anything that you're not going to use.
Yeah, the Canary Battle Axe is 90 AoE, and the Claymore 77. You know what? I think I'm going to keep the Inquisition weapons just for the sake of keeping them. Like, hey, this is what you start out with.
You can't salvage those. You can't salvage those.
Oh, you can't eat? Oh, okay. That's... Yeah, I see. Sucks, I guess. Oh, shit. I forgot to put the Legionnaire's plate on my character.
You can always go back and do that.
Oh, Legionnaire only. Oh, never mind.
Yeah,
no, right.
It's only for your dwarf. Yeah. You have to craft different armor upgrades for each character, so as you can tell, it would take a lot of crafting supplies.
I forgot to put on the... Oh, it is equipped. The Skywatch's lamellar? Is that how it's pronounced? Lamellar?
I don't even know. I'm not looking at it. I don't remember what it's called.
Okay. It was already automatically on anyway, the lamellar armor. But the Legionnaire's plate, Oathbound, though, that apparently, you know, that's the Legionnaire. Well, I guess I can do Legionnaire next. I'm gonna go Rogue. Frig that. I want to try Rogue. Select abilities.
Each character, warriors give you Constitution. Mages give you willpower, and rogues give you cunning. Even though mages are probably the easiest ones to play to start off with, constitution is really good for health and survivability, and cunning from a rogue is really good for range defense, which is the main problem, and survivability.
Okay. Well, so right now,
and warriors are really good to promote.
I'm going to spend my 1 point that I got from leveling up.
Oh, sorry. No, I'm still here. Go ahead.
50%.
Do you care if I invite someone to the party, too, or no? It's that other new player who, or not new player, but player who doesn't play this game ever. I feel bad, kind of, just, not sure.
Yeah, sure.
His name's Johnny, he's from Ahana's stream too, but he's a really cool dude.
Right.
He's, I can suggest it.
Korth Smite? So how do I know I have something already purchased?
Your skills?
Yeah.
It's highlighted.
I know, this kind of looks like it's highlighted. Okay. Yeah, alright. It's just a map. Alright, I see what's going on here. Alright. Learn. Wait, what?
You can make your character talk by hitting the left or right button. Right button is to praise your teammates, and the left button is to say, like, retreat or something.
Oh, okay. Well, I learned the Coupe de Grace, but I went to press triangle to apply, and I can't get it to apply for some reason.
That's because it's a passive. Circles are passives, and triangles, or the square diamond shape, are abilities that you can use. The passives are abilities that you can't map, but they will take effect always. Like I said, passives. Because you can only have four active abilities at once.
Okay. Alright. That's one of those scarier parents. Portions, yes, during the next operation. Okay. Hooray for healing potions. Alright, hold on, I'm gonna see how much time I got left.
I suggested Johnny to invite the party to this
project. Right. I didn't know you meant like the party chat. I thought you meant like party as in like in the game.
Oh, it's up to you if you want to do that. Like I said, if you don't want to, that's totally fine. But I just figured I would because I don't want to be,
Right. I understand. I just don't really know who the guy is. 479. Okay, 15 minutes left. I'm gonna do another run with the thing. Oh, come on. You ready to head out on another operation? Select quick match or create match to start a new multiplayer session.
Oh, okay. So you can't do it again.
That stinks.
We'll only give you free experience and gold one time. Except for all the free chests they give you.
Right. I was kind of hoping maybe doing it again, but just like, you know, to try out the other characters without actually, you know, instead of doing an actual match or anything.
You could do like a public game on routine or just solo or a routine game to see how the characters play while you're waiting. If you'd like.
I guess I'll wait. Wait, how do I switch characters then?
You hit triangle. Oh, is the tutorial still up for you or something?
I guess so.
It's still acting like you are in the training grounds to so you have to go through all the prompts before you are able to change characters, I guess. Because that's what it seems like from
your end?
Yeah, from watching the stream, I see, like, a prompt on the, like, the towards the middle of your screen that is saying, it's, like, giving you advice or something, I would assume.
Yeah, I'm still, like, it told me to, like, go into, like, create match and whatever, blah, blah, blah. So I went into create match and I came back and it still won't allow me to click it. I'm like, okay.
That is really weird. Pretty balls.
Oh, I do got two acolyte fire staffs.
I'm such a dick. Whenever my friend Johnny goes down, I'm like, fine work. I make my character praise him. I'm such a jerk. He's a cool dude, though. He's a really easy guy to get along with.
Okay.
Johnny knows it's all in good fun. Okay, I guess he's open. It's up to him what he wants to do.
Let's see. Okay. I'm able to do it again. All right.
You're able to change your character?
Yep. And enter proving grounds, apparently. I'll try Keeper. Alright. After completing this, I should be able to just, you know. Shit. I said something about treasure rooms, I didn't get to read it.
Oh, can you do the proof?
Yep.
Okay. This is weird how that works out.
Yeah, apparently I had to go to my inventory and view every single weapon that I got that was brand new or something. And then... Plus 8 gold. Oh my baby. We're rolling in it now. Oh.
How much gold did it give you?
8.
Yeah, see that? It might not want you to be able to.
Well, to be honest, the last time I did it, like, I was picking up, like, plus 7 gold and stuff like that as well, but it was just mainly. Sometimes they gave me plus over 10, but if I was opening chests, they would give me, like, plus, you know, 20-something or 30-something or whatever it was.
Oh, okay, that's what it is. Oh, so it is pretty much lower than routine gold. It's just, like, freebie. Here's some free gold.
Him from behind, or you know, they can just kill him before I get the chance to. That's good too. Wait, is there two mages on my team? No. Okay.
No, Johnny, no. Oh, he died.
Dispel barrier. Some areas are blocked by magical. Okay, that's what the mage is for. Alright. Nice. Yay, a chest. 14 gold. Anything you don't think you'll use. Yeah. For materials. The broad in your roster of allies. Watch for their armor and your requisitions, or break down the gear you don't need. You know, playing this makes me want to just sit and play an open world game now for some reason. I don't know why. Times might be desperate,
but no one's fighting naked. But that's what Dragon Age is though.
Like, you could always play a single player if you want. But I mean, like, and like more of like a sandbox style, in a sense. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, maybe not sandbox, but I mean, like, I know this is an open world game, but I mean more along the lines of like, crap. Like, you know, like something else. Like, oh, I know where I had to go. I had to go up those stairs down there. Herp-a-derp. I'm trying to think of the name of the, thing there. Like, I mean, this isn't, like, open world, like the multiplayer, obviously, but...
Yeah. The game's pretty open world, though, the single player. I mean, there are story missions, and there are things you have to do to progress the story, but you can go other places and explore other zones without having to progress the story.
Right. Oh, yeah, I dispelled this room. Okay, so if I dispelled this room, and it came from here. Okay, here it is. Wasn't sure where it was. Here we go. I got it under control now. I know what I'm doing. Oh.
The two tankiest classes in this game, the two strongest classes, are the Arcane Warrior and the Legionnaire. The Arcane's probably more so than the Lego, but the Lego is a very strong character too.
Alright. You know what there needs to be done? You know what needs to be a thing, I should say?
What's that?
Lego Dragon Age.
That'd be kind of funny.
That would be awesome. Make it open world and have, like, instead of it play, like, Lego games, have it play like this. That would be pretty awesome. But I don't think it would ever work out all that well. Because people will probably be like,
"I don't like it."
What's that? Sorry.
Like Lego would have to get the rights to Dragon Age from EA, and that would cost them money. I don't know if it's worth their licensing them to do that.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if they'd be willing to pay the licensing to the rights to Dragon Age. It's not like Star Wars or Batman, or something that huge.
Right.
But it would be.
But I mean. It would give them something new to, like, do, as in, like, try. Like, I mean... In the sense of speaking, like, oh, well, I mean, we done Star Wars up to the bajillionth time. We done Indiana Jones. We done Batman. So, how about we take on, like, see if we can get a new IP from someone else. Oh, yeah, and then they also done Marvel.
There needs to be a Lego dating simulator. That's what they should do next.
Oh my god. Can you imagine? Oh yeah, baby. Can you imagine Lego The Sims?
Rated MA. This Lego dating sim is rated MA.
Yeah.
For partial Lego nudity. Oh my god.
That would be awesome. I'd buy that.
I don't know. Probably would have to look into a Let's Play, just for morbid curiosity.
I'd be like, let's do a Let's Play of Lego dating simulators. That would be great. That would be awesome.
And if any of you viewers are wondering, yes, I am normally like. That's just for clarification.
How many people are watching right now?
It says two right now, but there were more earlier.
Yeah, I seen that, but then that little hiccup happened, you know, with the whole DLC and crap.
It must be getting close to being done now.
Yeah, it should be. Recover the heirlooms. Okay.
Are you sure you don't want to chat with Johnny?
Yeah, okay, I can.
Because he invited me to a party too, and I don't want. I'm not gonna like leave your party and join his, but I feel bad.
Right. Yeah, I guess I can invite him. I'll take your word that he's a good guy. I kind of don't really want to leave this hanging, because there's a question mark back there. Yeah, no. I'm going for that question mark back there. I don't know what it is. Come on. If only you could run faster. Oh yeah. Save that barrier, I guess. Am I already here? Nope. Oh yes, okay.
I have literally gotten every single item available in this game. Pretty stupid.
So how do you view the leaderboards?
They're a good indication of who spends a lot of time playing this game. That's about it. Either that or who used double XP lobbies a lot. But it still takes time, even after that, to stay high on the leaderboards, because the game's been out long enough, and the double XP lobbies were only a few weeks. But that being said, you could rack up a shit ton of experience on the... A shit ton of prestige from the double XP ladders.
Yeah, I was telling my viewers / people who are gonna watch this on YouTube that I was playing with somebody who was at, you know, rank number 2 in the leaderboards.
I'm not anymore. I'm like 13 or something, because I stopped playing for a long time.
Yeah, that I mentioned that too. I was just like, yeah, my friend here hasn't played this in a while. He went back to drumming, and now he's probably not even in the top 10 but anymore. He's probably lower, but who knows? I could be wrong. I don't know. And I was just like, but we'll check it out some point during the stream. And I didn't know how. That's why I was asking.
So when you finish with this proving ground, are you gonna invite Pat then, or invite Nicolin?
Invite who?
Nicolin is Johnny to the He is a... Arcane Warrior in your party. Yeah, that other mage that you were saying. Do I have two mages in my party? Yeah, the one is an Arcane Warrior. The elf in the golden dress up. You have a Lego archer, it looks like. Either that or a hunter. There's only two bow people. No, that's a hunter. You have a hunter. No, that's an archer. I'm sorry, I couldn't tell. That's an archer wearing the starting gear.
Do you think they're going to give me another chest, or do you think it's not?
Probably not, but I'm not sure. Maybe.
Probably not.
I don't know.
I'll see you here in a moment. Just waiting for this camera to start rotating around the characters.
Oh, you won. So you can check the DLC and all that, too.
You're in operation early for... I'll quit out. Okay. Yeah, well, that makes sense. If you quit out, you'd lose your XP, gang. Makes sense. Level 2 Keeper. 183 gold. 13 minutes and 5 seconds. Oh, right, I beat my previous time by, like, a minute. Just to be on the safe side. Any chests? Anything? Oh, no, it's not. This one actually costs money. Nope, no free chests. No free chests. Impossible. Not happening. I'm gonna, I guess, go back to Avar. Alright, let me check the download. Alright, what are we at? Oh, it's installed. Okay, good.
Yep. Party, and then
done.
To him that you're ready to go and we can both lose
and start a new match with you.
Yeah, it's already done.
Cuz I don't we just started.
Did you tell him that I'm streaming?
No. But what's up, Johnny? How you doing, man? Pest is streaming right now, just so you know.
Yeah.
If you, if we can both leave and join his game. He was missing some DLC, so I was playing without him, but he should be all ready to go, and we could join his game now since this just started. If that's cool with you. Alright, so I'm going to head off this match then. Give them a host.
Alright. Let's see here.
I know you beat Heartbreaker,
so you have to be decent to do that. And this is Pest's first favorite. It's his first time playing this game, so
yeah.
No pressure.
Complete noob.
Yeah, it's not a particularly hard game. It just requires time and teamwork. That's about it. And not even teamwork if you have crazy good items.
By the way, I did send you an invite. Actually,
I
might even be able to. Oh, actually, I can send Nickel in here. What? All right, maybe I have to leave and come back and forth to like kick in like, "Oh, you got this." Okay.
You have to like close the game and restart the game.
Yeah. Okay, for those who are watching on Twitch right now, just
related.
Give it like a few moments, and if it doesn't load up, and then refresh the page or something, but I will be back. Or we will be back.
When you start the
game, can you check on the related items and my add-on to just see if it was mine? Because I know you should have everything installed.
Yeah.